pleasant good morning to the brethren, and good morning to our first time viewers. Welcome to CUREP Pentecostal Empowerment Ministries International. We are happy to have you. We continue with our theme, Empowered by His Spirit, Growing to Greatness. And as such, we want to read Romans chapter 8, verse 15 to 17, and Hebrews chapter 12, from verse 25 to 29. Shall we read together? Romans chapter 8, let's take it up from verse 15, and it reads, "For ye have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but ye have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. And if children, then heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ. If so be that we suffer with him, that we may be also glorified together." And our second reading is taken from Hebrews chapter 12, and let's take it up from verse 25, and it reads, "See that ye refuse not him that speaketh. For if they escape not who refused him that spake on it, much more shall not we escape if we turn away from him that speaketh from heaven, whose voice then shook the earth, but now he hath promised, saying, Yet once more, I shake not the earth only, but also heaven. And this word, yet once more, signifieth the removing of those things that are shaken, as of things that are made, that those things which cannot be shaken may remain. Wherefore, we receiving a kingdom which cannot be moved, let us have grace, whereby we may serve God acceptable with reverence and godly fear. For our God is a consuming fire." Thank you, Lord, for your word. Let us pray. Almighty God, creator of the ends of the earth, we give you all the honor, all the glory, all the praise. God, there is none like you, none to be compared to you, none in heaven, none in the earth, none beneath the earth. We commit this morning service into your hand, God. Let your name be glorified. We pray, O God, for that person who might be stressed out at this point in time. We pray that they will receive your peace, peace of mind. God, that person that needs healing right now, someone might be infected with this virus. We claim your healing for them right now in the name of Jesus. God, by your stripes, we are healed. And we receive your healing now. We send that word of healing in Jesus' name. I pray that you will give that person that deliverance, that person whoever needs it right now. We send your word to deliver, to set free in the name of Jesus. We pray for that individual who needs salvation. Let your word go forward with power today, God. Minister unto our pastor as he brings forward your word. Let it touch lives today, O God. We come against every blockage of the enemy right now. We rebuke you, Satan. We set those minds free to hear and to receive the good news of the gospel. God, we lift up our worship team, oh God. Let that song that goes forward, let it minister unto those hearers, oh God. The band as they play, oh God, let that song go forward and minister unto those that hear, oh God. So we commit this entire service into your hand. Let your name be glorified. God, we pray for our nation in a special way. Oh God, our leaders, we lift up our leaders, God, before you. We pray for President Excellency Paula May Weeks. We pray for Prime Minister, the Honorable Dr. Keith Rowley. We pray for the Honorable Kamala Prasad Bisesa. We pray for each and every member of Parliament right now. God, preserve them, protect them, keep them. God, save them. As they sit to deliberate, oh God, help them to make laws that would benefit Trinidad and Tobago. Good laws, God, in the name of Jesus, God. Minister in a special way unto our commissioner of police, Gary Griffith. Give him wisdom. Give him the strength to execute his duties with excellence, Almighty God. Minister unto our minister of health. Give him the wisdom. Give him the understanding. Be with him at this point in time as we navigate through this pandemic, oh God. Be with our leaders. Be with us in this island of Trinidad and Tobago. Give us your peace. Provide, oh God, for those who need right now. In the name of Jesus, be glorified in today's service. In Jesus' name, and we thank you for doing it. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise the Lord. At this time, we would like to welcome our worship team. I encourage you to join in as we worship.
We thank you for the opportunity, God. Oh God, we thank you. Special place of worship. Thank you for coming down. Hallelujah.
We dedicate this time to you.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, for this precious time of worship. Feel free to dance where you are. Make some room, because we want to celebrate the presence and the love of the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
I will celebrate, sing unto the Lord. I will sing to Him a new song. I will celebrate, sing unto
to be praised.
Hey!
Sing unto the Lord on the earth. victory over the COVID. Hallelujah. Victory in the name of Jesus today. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. We worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. In spite of what is happening in our nation, we call upon a God who is faithful, a God who will never leave us, a God who blesses nations. And we thank Him for our voice being added to that wonderful song in His ear today. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We praise You, God. We thank You, Jesus. It's a privilege. It's an honor. Hallelujah, Jesus.
No one else.
Give him a praise. Let's lift your hands. Whatever your situation is today, no job, nothing, and you don't know, but just give him your praise. Lift your hands right where you are. He's not ashamed to come into your bedroom, into your living space. He meets you where you are. Hallelujah. Let's worship the King of Kings in spite of where we are. Let's honor him with our lives. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Almost 2,000 years ago, he died for us. We want to sing this song to commemorate that and to remind ourselves of his unfailing love. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man, you were here before above all kingdoms.
Like to have the ministry of the word by our pastor, the Reverend Dr. Melch Pope.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. To God be the glory, great things he had done. He continues to do it. He's very much alive on planet Earth. Yes, he has promised to show himself strong on the behalf of those who will put our trust in him. Bless his name. A pleasant good day to you and greetings in the name of Jesus, the name that is above every name. What a privilege and an honor it is again for us to connect with each other. We have chosen to commit this time to him, and certainly we will commune. We would have fellowship with him and then with each other. We understand the restrictions. However, Jesus said that he will build his church and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Matthew, the 16th chapter and the 18th verse. So God continues to show himself strong on our behalf. We want to go into the word of the Lord this morning. Thank God for a sweet time of fellowship and worship in his presence. Bless his name. So let us pray. Yes, we need him. His divine intervention is so important. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. Give him some worship this morning. Give him some praise. Hallelujah. He is the majestic one, the one who is worthy to be praised. We bless your name, Father, because you are our rock and our fortress and our deliverer and a strong tower. You are our light and our salvation. You are the strength of our lives, and we worship you. We adore you. We glorify you today, O precious Father. We thank you for the many. We thank you for the church. We thank you for those who continue to connect with us, O God. May we all receive today, as you continue to reveal Jesus the Christ in us, through us, for us, hallelujah, making us more than conquerors. So we lift up Jesus the Christ today. Be thou glorified, we pray, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Blessed be the wonderful name of the Lord. We continue to draw from the Holy Spirit today as we are empowered by Him. And we grow, we continue to grow to greatness. Grow. Hallelujah. He who humbles himself will be exalted. He gives grace to the humble. He who is prepared to make the necessary sacrifices to put the Lord first, as we seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness. And all these things shall be added unto us. Let's continue to draw and seek to be led by His Spirit as we continue to grow. I want to address your attention. Of course, we are on Romans, the 8th chapter, from the 14th verse, or from the 15th verse. But I want to look at, I want to read 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 30 and 31. But of Him are ye in Christ Jesus, who of God is made unto us wisdom and righteousness and sanctification and redemption, that according as it is written, He that glorieth, let him glory in the Lord. You see, we continue to draw from Him. We are not called to live this life by ourselves and in our own strength, because we will fail. Remember, the Bible reminds us in Isaiah chapter 64 and verse 6 that all our righteousnesses are as filthy rags. So we draw from Him, Jesus the Christ. Hallelujah. And let's go to the text. Romans, the 8th chapter, from the 14th verse. For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. Very, very important. Because we had some reading earlier, so we're going to go into it now. Last week, we touched, and I say touch because the Word of God is inexhaustible. The more we look into it, it is referred to by James, in the book of James, the first chapter, as the perfect law of liberty. James chapter 1. I give you the opportunity to search that out. What we are finding is that as we seek to understand what the Spirit of God is saying to us, remember, we are empowered by His Spirit. We saw where the wretchedness that Paul was speaking about in Romans chapter 4, verses 25 and 26, verses 24 and 25 rather, we see where he sought and he got his deliverance through Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. Yes? It was said of John Newton, and he was an 18th century, he lived in the 18th century. He captained a number of ships carrying slaves back and forth from the New World from the Old World, the first known world, into the Third World. Of course, later he sought and he fought for the abolition of the slaves, because he, after reading the Word of God, he recognized that man, regardless of their look and their color, is made in the image and likeness of God. So he fought for the abolition of the slave trade. He sought to bring it, he fought to bring it to an end. He was very, very instrumental, John Newton. And he exclaimed, and I quote, "I am not what I ought to be. I am not what I want to be. I am not what I hope to be in another world. But still, I am not what I once used to be. And by the grace of God, I am what I am." And I believe he would have read 1 Corinthians 15 and verse 10, when the Apostle Paul, understanding God's grace towards him, he says, "But by the grace of God, I am what I am." And this grace worked abundantly. This grace that was bestowed upon me, I was able to do the work of God. He says, and it's not so much, it's not me, but it is the grace of God working with me. I was able to accomplish so much. Hallelujah. And I want to strengthen it when he said in Galatians 2:20 and 21, he says, "I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I, but Christ lives in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me." Verse 21 of Galatians chapter 2, he says, "I do not frustrate the grace of God. For if righteousness comes by the law, then the death of Christ is in vain." And this righteousness he's talking about here, in the book of Romans, the 5th chapter, is referred to as justification. And I'm going to touch on this a little. We find that as we seek to grow to greatness, being empowered by his Spirit, Romans chapter 8 becomes, as it were, the jewel, that shining jewel, that piece of that great diamond on a ring, as it were. Especially you ladies who like to display your wedding bands, you know, your rings. Yes, we find that That the book of Romans, the 8th chapter, it's a chapter that would lift your spirit. The more you read it, is the more you would want to read it, and the more you're able to glean. So I encourage you to get back into Romans, the 8th chapter. Praise be unto God. We said that when it comes to the book of Romans, the 8th chapter, it speaks of the new law, verses 1 to 4. What is the new law? It is called the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus. So you see what the Spirit of God is able to do in us, through us, and for us. He takes us to the next level, the law of the Spirit of life. You see, so many people bask in the Ten Commandments and seek to even argue as though that will save us. No, the law cannot save. The keeping of it doesn't save us. If righteousness comes by the law, then the death of Christ is in vain. The Holy Spirit takes us into a new level. Hallelujah, I am walking by the Spirit. It is called the law of the Spirit of life. Romans chapter 8 and verse number 2. The law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free from the law of sin and death. Because the Bible reminds us in 2 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 6 that the letter killeth, but the Spirit gives us life. He has made us able ministers of the new covenant, of the new testament, of the new agreement. Hallelujah. Christ in us, the hope of glory. Colossians chapter 1 and verse number 27. Then verses 5 to 13, we spoke of the new struggle. What's the new struggle? The flesh continues to work against the Spirit, the work of the Spirit in our lives. Look at Romans chapter 8 and verse 6. For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. And the Apostle Paul reminds us in Galatians, the 5th chapter, the 16th and 17th verses. He says, this I say then, walk in the Spirit, live in the Spirit, allow the Spirit of God to control your life, and you shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Very, very important. Galatians 5, 16 and 17. Because there's the fight. The Spirit lusteth against the flesh, and the flesh is always fighting to control. And if we continue like this, we know this cannot please God. For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. No wonder why the Bible tells us in Romans chapter 14 and verse number 17, for the kingdom of God is not in meat and drink, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. Then we talk in Romans the 8th chapter, we're talking not only about a new law, a new struggle, but also a new man. Look at verses 14 to 17, a new man. Let's pull verse number 16 of Romans chapter 8. The Spirit himself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. Hallelujah. We are the children of God. Our Creator, the one who made the heavens and the earth. Hence the reason we are called to stay focused as we continue to look unto Jesus, who is the author and finisher of our faith. Hebrews chapter 12 and verse number 2. A new man, 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse number 17, strengthens this when the Bible tells us, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. All things are passed away, and behold, all things are become new. There is a new perspective. New man, a new man, hallelujah, a new woman, glory be to God. And the work starts on the inside, and then we have the manifestation of it on the outside. Blessed be the wonderful name of the Lord. This is why Jesus gives the peace that passes all understanding, able to keep our hearts and our minds through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Philippians chapter 4 and verse number 7. Then we come to a new creation. A new creation. Glory be to God. We can use again 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse number 17. But of course, this has to do with the physical world. God is going to do something great. There will be a new heaven and a new earth wherein dwelleth righteousness. 2 Peter chapter 3 reminds us of this. So we need to get ready and stay ready. Hallelujah. Stay prepared. And the way you do that is by getting involved in the things of Almighty God. Making disciples. Allowing our light to so shine before men that they may behold our good works and glorify the Father who is in heaven. We are living in exciting times. Hallelujah. Many of us have been given the privilege of spending more time at home. So that, you know, the reason for that as a child of God, I believe that God is allowing this so that we can spend time in His Word, spend time in His presence, so that we continue to be strengthened by His Spirit in the inner man. Hallelujah. Allowing Christ to dwell in our hearts by faith, that we being rooted and grounded in love will be able to comprehend with all the saints what is the length and the breadth and the height and the depth of God, and to know the love of Christ which passeth all knowledge, that we would be filled with all the fullness of God. He desires for us to continue to connect with Him. He is the true vine and we are the branches. Let's draw from Him so that we can grow to greatness. Hallelujah. Doing all that He desires for us to do while we live on earth. The new creation. The creation is groaning because it awaits the manifestation. Look at verse number 21 of Romans chapter 8. Because the creature itself also shall be delivered from the bondage of corruption into the glorious liberty of the children of God. Hallelujah. What a tremendous privilege given to us to share God's word, to experience its manifestation. Just like we're told in John 1:14, and the word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and of truth. Oh, glory be to God. Jesus makes it clear in John the 15th chapter and the 16th verse. He says, you did not choose me, but I chose you and ordained you that you should go and bring forth fruit and that your fruit should remain. Hallelujah. It is not by might, not by power, but by my spirit, said the Lord of hosts. Zechariah chapter 4 and verse number 6. Then a new body, a new body. Look at the 23rd verse of Romans, the 8th chapter. And not only they. Yes? Not only they. But ourselves also, which have the first fruits of the Spirit, even we groan, we ourselves groan within ourselves, waiting for the adoption, to wit, the redemption of our bodies. We are going to have a new body. Glory be to God. That's right. The apostle reminds us in 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter. Give me the opportunity, please, to get this. 1 Corinthians chapter number 15. And here's what it says here. Hallelujah. Concerning the body. It is sown from the 43rd verse. It is sown in dishonor. It is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness. It is raised in power. It is sown a natural body. It is raised a spiritual body. Glory be to God. We've got a house. We've got a building. This body, that's right. Hallelujah. The Bible reminds us in the book of Philippians, the 3rd chapter, verses 20 and 21. Yes, he will change our vile bodies, that it will be fashioned like unto his glorious body. Yes, some of us are living because of, you know, without the certain parts of our bodies, but we are here and we're praising God. Hallelujah. I want to say to us today, yes, we will have a new body. Thank you, Lord. And this body now, it is sown in corruption. It will be raised in incorruption. Blessed be the wonderful name of the Lord. A new body. It's going to give to us all, those of us who know him, who trust him. I want to ask of you today, who have never surrendered to his lordship, here is a tremendous opportunity for you to do so, to make it right, to call upon him where you are. The Bible says, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. For the same Lord over all is rich unto all who will call upon him. Romans chapter 10, verses 12 and 13. A new body. So there will not only be, there's not only in Romans the 8th chapter, a new law having been delivered from our wretchedness, from our sinfulness, from our weaknesses. A new struggle, which is a good one. A new man, a new creation, a new body, but also a new purpose. Romans chapter 8 and verse number 29. What's the purpose? For whom he did foreknow, he also did predestinate to be conformed to the image of his Son. Very, very important. To be conformed. To be transformed. To be like him. Hallelujah. We're reminded in Romans the 12th chapter, verses 1 and 2, when the apostle says, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies as living sacrifices, holy and acceptable unto God, which is our reasonable service, or our spiritual worship. And be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Romans 12, 1 and 2. Notice the change, the transformation. 2 Corinthians 5, 17. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creation. Hallelujah. The new man, the new person. Christ in me, the hope of glory. Intent on making a difference as we serve others, serve our community, serve our region, and serve our world. Hallelujah. Blessed be the wonderful name of the Lord. What a privilege to be serving the Lord at this time in history, when the world is in chaos, when man doesn't know what to do. Hey, hallelujah. If we would only allow him to use us, having empowered us and seek to be led by his Spirit, we can bring hope and comfort and strength and deliverance and blessing to the many who are calling upon him now for assistance. Praise be unto God. So, new purpose, to be conformed to the image of his Son. Blessed be the wonderful name of the Lord. Look at verse number 34. Who is he that condemned? It is Christ that died, yea, rather that is risen, who is even at the right hand of God, who also maketh intercession for us. So you're not alone in your situation, child of God. No, his grace is sufficient. Then there's a new security. New security. Look at verse number 37 of Romans chapter 8. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature, nor any other thing, nor any virus. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. We live in this world. Yes. But because of the Christ in us, we are not of this world, but he sent us into the world to make the difference. Jesus prayed for us in John the 17th chapter. He says, Father, I pray not that you take them out of the world, but that you keep them from the wicked one. Yes, hallelujah, a new security. What shall separate us from the love of God? Don't allow anything to cause you to be separated from him. He knows exactly what you're going through. He's touched with the feelings of our infirmities. He's saying, I will never leave you nor forsake you, so that we could boldly declare, the Lord is my helper, and I will not fear what man will do unto me. Hebrews 13, 5 and 6. So don't you give up. Don't you give in today. Hallelujah. The Lord is on your side. And if God be for us, who can be against us? It's right in the chapter here. Romans chapter 8 and verse number 31. Well, let me say to us again, I started with this last week, and I feel led of the Lord to say it again. Romans, the 8th chapter. It begins with no condemnation. It ends with no separation. And in between, all things work together for the good. Romans chapter 8 and verse number 28. So, we have what it takes to make a difference. We have what it takes to continue to be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Because we have overcome them, for greater is he who is in us than he who is in the world. 1 John chapter 4 and verse number 4. Will we continue? Will you continue to trust him? Yes, do so. He remains faithful. And he's not going to give us more than we can bear. Thank you, Father, that we are just into an overview of the chapter again. And there's so much that we can glean from it. Oh, for your word, which shall not return unto you void, but it shall accomplish that which you please, and it shall prosper in the thing for wherein you sent it. Thank you, Father. We received the word today in the name of Jesus the Christ. And now I pray that you would touch us, touch every believer, in our spirits, in our souls, in our bodies, understanding and knowing that, oh God, whatever trial, whatever testing comes our way, whether it be in the flesh, the body, oh God, whether it be in our minds, oh Father, whether it be in our spirits, you're well able to give deliverance. We bless you and we praise you. Oh God, infuse in us a freshness and a newness, oh Father, that will bring honor and glory to your name. Those who are discouraged, courage. Lift up today in the name of Jesus the Christ, the Son of the living God, giving us the enablement by the Spirit of God to do your will, to serve, enabled to disable, O God, because of the Spirit of God dwelling in us and through us. We give you praise, glory, and honor. For it's not by might, nor by power, but by my Spirit, said the Lord of hosts. Blessed be the wonderful name of the Lord. And what about you who are tuned in, locked in, but you're not saved? Why? What are you waiting on? Now is the accepted time. Now, the Bible reminds us that we ought not to receive the grace of God in vain. It's coming to you now. It's right here. It's before you. Grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. And it is His will that none should perish, but that all should come to repentance. Would you pray a simple prayer after me if you desire to receive Him into your life today and be saved? For except we repent, we shall all likewise perish. Will you say after me, please? Maybe you're a backslider and you desire to come back home. Yes, come back. This is your time. Now is the time. Say after me, please. Lord Jesus, I am a sinner. I have failed so many times in my own strength to make it right. But I've heard today that you love me. Forgive me now of all my sins. Wash me in your precious blood, Jesus. Come into my life now and save me. I confess you as my Savior and as my Lord. And I believe in my heart that you are alive and alive forevermore. So thank you now for saving me and writing my name in your book of life. Amen. Amen. And having prayed that prayer, welcome to the family of God. It's by faith. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And having done that, welcome. And I know that there's some numbers given there that you can call and connect. Bless you today. But let's continue to pray, call upon Him. Maybe you're not well in body, in mind, but God is able. Father, now in the name of Jesus Christ, I stretch forth my hands to those who are not well in body. We know we will be given a new body, but even now, the Holy Spirit, I speak, oh God, the same Holy Spirit is able to quicken our mortal bodies. Oh God, thank you for this quickening power of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus the Christ, in us and through us. I speak the word of healing and of deliverance now. I speak the word of strength and protection. For he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. O God, for surely your goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Lord, meet the needs of your people today, spiritually, physically, socially, financially, oh God, emotionally, in the name of Jesus the Christ. Blessed be his wonderful name. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For the glory of God. He reigns, and he reigns supreme. Praise his name. I want to thank you for your ongoing support. We need your financial contributions. Yes, you continue to do so, and we bless God for you. But there are many of you who continue to say, I want to be able to do something. Yes, you can call, and the intercessors, those on the line, will be happy to direct you accordingly. God bless you as we all work together for the advancement of the kingdom of God. Aren't you excited? Yes, you ought to be in the midst of all that is happening. God remains faithful. Watch out. Expect his miracles to come your way. Praise be unto God. Well, until we meet again, remember we come together on Tuesday evening for our prayer meeting and Bible study via Facebook and YouTube. Minister Sherlene Pope continues to teach on the church. Very, very, very powerful and enlightening. Yes, maybe there's some things you know already, but it's a reminder as we continue to forge ahead and advance his kingdom on the earth. Hallelujah. Blessed be the wonderful name of the Lord. So remember, we are not going under. We have the victory. Why? Because Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The Lord bless you and your household. Stay safe. Amen. And amen.
Thank you, Pastor, for the ministry of the word, and thank you, viewers. If you have been blessed by this ministry, we encourage you to like, to share, to subscribe to our various social media platforms. Please note that our offices are open on Monday and Friday from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. Also, if you would like to support us financially, our account information is listed below. Be safe, stay blessed. We will see you again next week.
Show me your face. Fill up this space. My world needs you.